Hey GMS, I'm Raina, and I'm your host for this week's GMTV. Now let's head over to Maddie and Megan for news.
Good afternoon, GMS. I'm Maddie Cross.
And I'm Megan Fleischer, and this is your GMS news.
Student Council will be meeting next Thursday, March 13th, in Mr. Deacon's room right after school.
Students and staff, don't forget this Saturday night is Spring Forward. Set your clocks ahead 1 hour this weekend.
Eighth graders, you will be receiving information about the Colorado trip in your science classes on Friday, March 14th. You will be able to pick up applications that day as well. For more information, see Mr. Bergdahl or Ms. Blosser.
All GMS students grades 6 to 8 are invited to participate in Hoops Night on March 28th. See Mr. Deegan in room 105 to sign up your team of friends. Teams can be 6 to 8 players and can be co-ed. There will be a 3-point and half-court contest. The sign-up deadline is March 21st.
Students, the ISMA contest is March 21st and March 22nd, Friday the 21st from 5 to 10 and 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. on Saturday the 22nd.
Our GMS PE department held their Jump Rope for Heart event on February 24th and raised $803 for the American Heart Association. Josh Hames raised the most donations. Good job, Josh.
Congratulations to the 6th grade students of the month. Zane Adams, Juan Aguilar, Coriana Barnes, Cielo Charvea, Sarah Flores, Evelyn Garcia, Natalie Hendricks, Thomas Santos, Monse Vila, and Mia Wellington. Great job, guys.
Any 8th grader interested in taking Goshen High School Summer PE should pick up a registration form in the main office. The cost this year will be $90 and will cover various activities and transportation. Forms and money must be turned in no later than Friday, March 21st to the bookkeeper in the main office.
I'm Maddie.
And I'm Megan.
And this has been your GMS News.
Have a great weekend, GMS.
Have you heard?
The R word is out.
It used to be that you could call a person retarded.
If they were slow.
Or acted dumb.
Or stupid.
Or if they were born with Down syndrome.
Or anything else that made them appear to be different.
But the R word shows lack of sensitivity.
Or compassion.
Or understanding.
It hurts.
It's insulting.
It's offensive.
And people with intellectual disabilities
can accomplish great things.
We need a new R word.
Respect.
Spread the word to end the word. Take the pledge at rword.org.
With top-tier weather technology.
It's about to get snowed.
With the most dedicated crew.
Oh my gosh, I have to! I think there's a very big chance of a snowstorm coming our way! Oh my!
On the dot weather accuracy.
It could get sunny.
And reporting in the most severe conditions.
This freezer for about 8 weeks.
This is GMTV weather.
Good afternoon, GMS. It's your weatherman, Jason Marijuana, with your weekend weather for Friday, March the 7th. Today, we've been seeing some rocking highs of 42 and down lows of 28. And the sky won't be able to make up its mind with those partly cloudy skies. Then we'll be sneaking up on tomorrow when it's snowing again, even though we're already in March. It's colder than today with a high of 34 and a low of 16. Finally, it's mostly cloudy with a high of 30 and a low of 21. So basically, the highs are progressively getting colder, even though we're supposedly getting spring. What if it can just do whatever it wants just because it's weather? Well, tired of your garbage weather. Tired. Bye, make the best of your weekend even though the weather's in its bratty face.
Wrestling with Pierre Moran, Goshen 157-52. By pin, it was Braxton Rodriguez, Noah Shively, and Daniel Hidalgo. Girls JV Swimming, Goshen lost a hard one with 39 against Concord 101. Standout performance was Sarita Moore with 2 5th place finishes. Girls Varsity Swimming, Goshen lost another hard one against Concord with 68-210. Stand-up performance is Casey Yoder with the best time of 50 backstroke. In boys JV, Goshen went against Elkhart West, 88-36. Congrats to Mason Schrock for the 100 IM and 100 free. In girls varsity swimming, it was Goshen against Westside with 202-42. Stand-up performance was Anna Pacow with first place finishing in the 100 free and 50 fly. In boys varsity swimming, it was Goshen against Concord. It was 128-146. Kate Fisher was a stand-up performer. We made a record the first place finish in the 50 backstroke. Boys JV swimming, it was Goshen against Concord. We won 86-47. The first place finishers were Mason Schrock, Evan Saylor, and Gabe Goertz. Girls JV swimming, it was Goshen against Elkhart West, 92-46. One of the first placers was Jessica Rhodes in the 25 back. Good job. 8th grade varsity basketball, it was Goshen against Pierre Moran with 27-37. Some of the leading players were Brooke Bechtel with 10 points and 4 steals, Jill Kissinger with 5 points, and Raina Schreiner-Barger with 4 points. 7th grade varsity girls basketball, it was Pierre Moran against Goshen. It was 39-9. The stand-up performer was Josie Walters with 15 points. In boys varsity swimming, it was Goshen against Westside with 192-30. And one of the standout first place finishers was Daniel Saylor for the 500 and 100 freestyle.
Hey Goshen Middle School, ready for today's drawing for the PBS tickets? We're going to start with 8th grade. All right. Hope I can read this name. This name is Ashley Ramirez for Mr. Wren. Excellent job, Ashley. Yay! All right. 7th grade. 7th grade ticket winner. The 7th grade ticket winner is Austin Peeler? Peeler. Austin Peeler for responsibility. Good job, Austin. Yay! And 6th grade. 6th grade, you have the most tickets in here. I must say I'm impressed. 6th grade winner is Naomi Magalanes. So good job, Naomi. 6th grade. And staff. Staff, there's not very many, so I'm thinking your odds are pretty good that I'm gonna draw. Mrs. Hall, 6th grade teacher Mrs. Hall for productivity. Good job, Mrs. Hall. Yay! Keep earning those tickets. Good job, Goshen Middle School.
Clouds, whoa, oh, 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 whoa, oh, 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 oh.
how to metaphorically destroy the I-STEP test. Remember to practice regularly with worksheets. Pace yourself.
This one, nope. This one, nope. Huh. That'd do good on a test. Huh. Yellow. A, B, C. D, C, B, A, C, D, S, J, K, L, P, L, K, Q, yeah! I'm not sure about that one. I'll get back to that. Oh yeah, who knows? Yeah, okay. Oh, now I remember this one.
Get a good night's sleep. Eat a nutritious and delicious breakfast. If you follow these steps, you'll succeed in the I-STEP test.
Everything you held me down, but I got up. Oh. GMS. I'm here with this week's Spotlight student, Angel Areola. Can you tell us about some of your work with Feed the Children America?
We boxed 280 boxes. There was like 30-some people that did it with us for like packing.
Cool. So you packed 280?
Yeah, but I had a person help me.
Cool. Okay. Well, congratulations. You have the Spotlight Award. There you go.
This has been your GMTV for Friday, March 7th. Have a great weekend.